Next important topic, half of the topic has been covered, it is definite integral. Now in the indefinite integrals, what we have done, what we have gone through the process, number one, we have gone through the basic integrations, fundamental integrations, integrations of some special functions, standard integrals, then we have gone for the integration by parts, integration by partial differentiation. Now all that were done in the indefinite integrals. Now we are for the definite integrals. Now what definite and indefinite, what is the difference between these two? Only words, not mathematically. What is the difference between these two words? For definite means having some solution. Okay. So now let me tell you, let me explain you some basic thing for the definite integrals. Now definite, number one is definite integral has a unique solution. Number one is definite integral, as the word means, definite integral has a unique solution. Has a unique solution. Second thing is how it is expressed. How it is expressed, how it is denoted. Now, number two is definite integral is denoted as, now how it is denoted, we are denoting it as a to b f x dx, where a is the lower limit of the integral, where a is the lower limit of integral and b is the upper limit, b is the upper limit of the integral. One thing, that to definite integral, how we are going to denote it. Now the main thing is now the definite integral, how it is introduced. Now the definite integral, the definite integral is introduced in, now it is introduced basically in two different ways. Now number one way is, it is called limit as a sum, that is called limit as a sum. This is the heading of the topic, limit as a sum. And number two, it is noted as, it has, number two, it has an antiderivative and antiderivative capital F. It means what? Definite integral. Now it has an antiderivative F in the closed interval, in the closed intervals, that is a comma b, then its value means a unique value. Okay, I'm just writing it, a unique value, its value, a unique, is expressed as fb minus fa. Now as we have done in class 11th, for the differentiation part, first of all we went with the first principle and then with the differentiation process, with the simple differentiation. Same thing is here, first of all we are going with the topic limit as a sum and then with the main topic. Now we will be discussing limit as a sum, then this portion we will be discussing with the fundamental theorem of calculus. Okay, these will be discussed in the fundamental theorem of calculus, and as the requirement we are going to solve with some very nice examples. Okay.